Good Tuesday evening and welcome to the NCW Life Evening News. I'm Grant Olson. Before we get to tonight's top stories, let's take a quick look outside our weather window, and a nice one on this Tuesday. We did see some cloudiness out there and some peaks at the sun. This is shot from Lake Chelan from this afternoon. A few more clouds over that way. We did see a little bit more blue sky here in the Wenatchee area. Temperatures were decent. And as we make our way into Wednesday, talk about decent temperatures. 60s. Yeah, they're a possibility for us all over the area tomorrow. We're about in the middle of that graphic, Wenatchee. We have at least a 70% chance that we will see 60 degrees tomorrow. Moses Lake, a 90% chance, a little bit less for you folks in OMAC. And we'll talk much more weather coming up a little bit later on. Now, a few of the stories we're following for you tonight. A man and woman have been charged in a series of car break-ins in local hotel parking lots in 2022, including an Anacortes cops car. An imprisoned felon who crashed into multiple vehicles on Valley Mall Parkway in 2011 fails to get his sentence overturned. And officials are working to repair both an irrigation canal failure and a destroyed section of Frenchman Hills Road between George and Warden, but there's still no estimate yet on when that road will reopen. But first, our top story tonight. A rock slide in Tumwater Canyon closed U.S. Highway 2 much of this morning. The Washington State Department of Transportation said crews had to blast the rocks and get the debris cleared from the highway. The slide west of Leavenworth happened about 7:30 this morning, with the highway reopened just before 11. Two people are suspected in a series of vehicle prowls earlier this year, including one that broke into a parked police car. 33-year-old Savannah Lynn Austin of Wenatchee is charged with second-degree vehicle prowl, unlawful firearm possession, and possessing stolen property. Wenatchee police say they'll seek similar charges against 34-year-old Colton James Nickel of Peshaston. The two allegedly broke into an Anacortes Police Department SUV last month, parked in the lot of a Wenatchee hotel. That same night, they're accused of stealing items from other vehicles in hotel lots in Wenatchee and Leavenworth. Many of the items were allegedly found in Austin's possession. Both suspects are being held in the Chelan County Jail. A prison inmate with a history of hit-and-run driving, including a multi-car smash-up on Valley Mall Parkway in 2011, won't receive an early release. 57-year-old Shannon Bruce Morley struck four other vehicles with a stolen 2008 Ford F-350 truck while fleeing from East Wenatchee Police in December of 2011. He was sentenced to 7 years in prison after pleading guilty to 8 criminal counts, including vehicular assault. He then went to prison again for violating federal probation and back to state prison for violating his probation in Douglas County. Morley filed a petition to end his sentence early because prison officials failed to calculate his time served on community custody. If successful, that would have shortened his prison time by a few weeks. But the State Court of Appeals ruled today that the time was properly calculated and Morley's release date remains set for April 4th of this year. Officials are working to repair both an irrigation canal and an irrigation canal failure that destroyed a section of Frenchman Hills Road between George and Warden, but there's still no estimate yet on when the road will reopen. The canal break early Friday morning flooded surrounding land and closed the roadway, as well as briefly knocking out power to more than 200 homes. Grant County Commissioners signed a declaration of local emergency on Friday in an effort to expedite the road repairs. Meanwhile, the Quincy Columbia Basin Irrigation District said Monday that repairs are underway to a feeder that serves the Frenchman Hills pumping plant. Crews have been on site working on the repair since Friday. Some irrigation customers in the area are likely to see a delay in spring water service while the repairs are made. Well, when we come back, Leavenworth residents will get insights next week into how recreationists are using the Wenatchee River. Chelan County Fire District 1 honored its Firefighters of the Year for both 2020 and 2021 recently at its annual appreciation banquet. The fourth tow plow to join the State Department of Transportation fleet needs an official moniker, and that's where you come in. And the state says Bob the Cat is back for his spring strolls from one side of Interstate 90 to the other. We'll show you the video. I'm Grant Olson, and you're watching the NCW Life Evening News.
Spring is more than just a time to clean. It's your time to renew, recharge, and spend time with the people you love. At Merry Maids, our cleaning services go beyond the basic services and provide you with a comprehensive clean that will re-energize your home and enhance your life. From everyday routine cleaning or deep cleanings, Merry Maids professional team members can provide you with an unrivaled experience. Call Merry Maids to schedule your cleaning today.
Traditional values and innovation in honoring the life of each family we serve is part of the ministry of Heritage Memorial Chapel. Our staff is committed to walk with your family with compassion through this time of grief. We are here to help and here to serve, the right kind of help when you need it most. Heritage Memorial Chapel.
The 2022 Grant County Fair is excited to announce country supergroup Lone Star. They'll be playing at the fairgrounds Thursday, August 18th. Friday, August 19th, it's Cameron Marlowe. And on Wednesday, August 17th, it's the tribute bands Jukebox Heroes, Barracuda, and Stone in Love. Three of the premier tribute bands on the West Coast. VIPC tickets go on sale March 11th. The Grant County Fair, August 16th through the 20th.
Welcome back. In another news, Leavenworth residents will get insights next week into how recreationists are using the Wenatchee River. Chelan County Commissioner Bob Bugert will host a March 31st community meeting at Barn Beach Reserve to discuss multiple Leavenworth issues, including the heavy use of the river by tubers and rafters each summer. An estimated 1,000 to 1,600 people float Icicle Creek and the Wenatchee River on summer weekend days, and Chelan County averages 3 to 5 drowning deaths a year, many of them occurring on that stretch of water. Other topics in the meeting include an update on short-term rental enforcement. A second community meeting follows on April 1st at Beaver Valley Lodge in Plain. You can find details, including a Zoom link to attend the meetings, at the web address on your screen. Chelan County Fire District 1 honored its Firefighters of the Year for both 2020 and 2021 recently at its annual appreciation banquet. As nominated by fellow firefighters and voted on by all members of the fire district, engineer Chris Paul received the 2020 award and firefighter Bryson Waller the honor for 2021. Both were praised for their skills and dedication to the citizens of the district. Well, it wouldn't officially be a Washington Highway snowplow without a funny name. The fourth tow plow to join the State Department of Transportation fleet needs an official moniker, and that's where you come in. Tow plows are attached to standard plow trucks to clear two lanes of snow at the same time. The DOT wants the public to weigh in on a selection of 16 names chosen from more than 1,000 initial suggestions. Possibilities include Plow Chicka Plow Plow, Snow Squatch, Sleddy Vetter, Snowy Juan Plow Noby, and a host of others. Head to the WashDOT Facebook page to make your selection. The survey closes at noon this Friday. For the record, the three other tow plows that keep state highways cleared are named Plowy McPlow Plow, the Big Leplowski, and Sir Plows-a-Lot. And before we take you to break, the state says Bob the Cat is back for his spring strolls from one side of Interstate 90 to the other. A camera at the Hayek Undercrossing showed the bobcat safely crossing beneath I-90 two or three times each spring before disappearing. Bob repeats the process early each winter. The Washington State Department of Transportation says it's possible it's not the same bobcat every time, but it likely is. You're watching the NCW Life Evening News. Coming up next, tonight's feature story and your complete local weather forecast. That and much more still to come on the NCW Life Evening News. Please stay with us.
At D.A. Davidson in Wenatchee, they believe your investment success begins with a personalized plan. A plan that is the roadmap you need to navigate your way to living your best years in retirement. D.A. Davidson can help you create a plan so you can take the time to enjoy the finer things in life. Let the financial advisors at D.A. Davidson help chart your retirement future today.
You love to help others. You need a solid career. You can have it all with help from Charter College. Our 10-month medical assistant program prepares you to work in healthcare settings like physician offices, rehab centers, and clinics. You'll learn to take patient vitals, assist with exams, administer injections, and maintain medical records. When you're ready to launch a rewarding healthcare career, visit chartercollege.edu, because we work to get you to work.
NCW Life really does a great job of exposing our brand. It's a little scary at first, right? You're just throwing money out there hoping it comes back. And to see those results come back through and see people walk through the door and say, hey, saw your TV advertisement. Those are the kinds of things that you see the return on. And when you look at the cost spent, you know you're making a return on it. There's a huge market here and market potential, and they are a great avenue for that.
Welcome back to the NCW Life Evening News. High school students from around North Central Washington are featured in the 43rd Regional High School Art Show ongoing right now at the Wenatchee Valley Museum and Cultural Center. From scores of entries, judges announced the winners in multiple categories, including Best in Show, at a reception earlier this month. The exhibit hangs through April 2nd, and then it's on to Olympia, where the artwork is entered in statewide competition. In tonight's feature story, we have a video showcase of the student work that received top local honors.
Thank you.
Beautiful artwork right there, wasn't it? Let's take a check now of your North Central Washington weather forecast. Hope your Tuesday was a good one. We started off on the kind of cool and cloudy side, but boy, things got much better here in the Wenatchee Valley this afternoon. Beautiful shot of the Wenatchee Valley from our cross camera up on Wenatchee Heights. We saw a mixture of clouds and sun this afternoon, and that allowed our temperatures to warm up, unlike other parts of our viewing area that stayed a little bit cloudier today. But look at that, our temperature 56 unofficially this afternoon. That's just a degree above 55, which is our normal temperature for this time of year. 71 is our record set back in 1978. This morning, we started off on the mild side. 43 degrees this morning, our overnight low. 35 is normal, and our record is 25 degrees set back in 1994. Sunrise before 7 a.m. now at 6:59, and the sun sets at 7:17. Heading into your hump day Wednesday, temperatures on the beautiful side. Look at all of the 60s, and I'll tell you a fact about that in a second. 65 in Moses Lake, 64 in Ephrata, 63 for Quincy, and 62 in Wenatchee, 61 tomorrow in Cashmere. We haven't hit a 60 degree day since December 1st. And remember December 1st? Dan Kuntz told me this fact this morning. We hit 70 degrees on December 1st. So this will be our warmest day going back to December 1st of last year. And it looks like a beauty for our Wednesday. As we take a look at our surface loop now, tonight we can expect partly cloudy skies. Still that ridge up and over the Pacific Northwest bringing us that nice weather today. Temperatures overnight tonight somewhere in the lower 40s. Here's that frontal boundary, and it's a bit of a cold front, not so much for Wednesday. We talk about it being warmer tomorrow. Could be a little bit breezy too. High pressure and low pressure here, and that could kick up winds, especially late tomorrow afternoon and into tomorrow night. Once again, temperatures in the low to mid 60s. Thursday, partly cloudy and cooler. That cold front begins to push in, and that'll keep our temperatures down pretty much into the middle 50s for Thursday. Partly cloudy then. Cold front slides into the Dakotas. High pressure ridge builds back in behind it. We're talking highs near 60 once again on Friday. Looks beautiful heading into the upcoming weekend too. Partly cloudy and mild on Saturday. High temperatures near 60. Another little area of storminess beginning to show its presence in our weather map, but really won't affect us all that much this weekend. But this could by Sunday evening, a 20% chance for showers, mostly cloudy, highs in the upper 50s. And this is late Sunday night, I think our best chance for rain here in the Wenatchee area. And then another chance for some more rain Monday morning before we clear out by the afternoon on Monday. Once again, it'll stay very nice with high temperatures predominantly in the upper 50s. Let's take a look at that 7-day forecast. Another mild one on tap for us tonight, overnight at 42. Let's circle this. Beautiful 62 degrees tomorrow, partly cloudy skies. A little dip in our temperatures as that weak cold front moves through Thursday, and then right back to the nice weather for both Friday and Saturday with partly cloudy skies. We'll see mostly cloudy skies. A weak weather system will move in late Sunday night, a 20% chance of rain in 58, and then morning showers for Monday, mostly cloudy with once again high temperatures around 58. And that's a look at your local weather forecast. Coming up next, tonight's sports report with Eric Granstrom and more as the NCW Life Evening News continues right after this.
The best pizza in the known universe is right here in downtown Chelan, so come on up. For the best locally crafted beer and barbecue in Chelan, come on up.
For the best down-home scratch country cooking in North Central Washington, you'll find it in Manson. Come on up.
Come on up.
Come on up.
Come on up.
What is home? A place to gather, a place to grow, provide shelter for the ones we love, eat, drink, restore, build trust. It's a place to rest when the work day is done. A place to find quiet after a night of good fun. What an honor we have at Guild to help own, finance, create, pave the way to live in home.
It has really been a great partnership between Succession and NCW Life. It's not always easy to sit in front of a camera or a microphone, but you guys have made it a really nice process.
It's a little scary at first, right? You're just throwing money out there hoping it comes back. And to see those results come back through and see people walk through the door and say, hey, saw your TV advertisement. Those are the kinds of things that you see the return on. And when you look at the cost spent, you know you're making a return on it. NCW Life really does a great job of exposing our brand and Succession Wines to North Central Washington. There's a huge market here and market potential that NCW Life is able to help us capture, spread who we are, and tell the world about what Succession does, and they are a great avenue for that.
And now it's a sports update on the NCW Life Channel.
And a happy Tuesday to you as we take a break from the madness of the NCAA tournament and wipe our tears away from the sorrow over our broken brackets. The NFL and spring baseball fill the void. Let's talk baseball first. Seattle played the Diamondbacks Monday at Salt River Fields at Talking Stick, Arizona. They let their bats do the talking with two home runs off Mariner starter George Kirby and a 9-1 win. Abraham Toro went 2-for-3 for Seattle with their lone RBI. Mike Ford continued to play well, going 1-for-1 with a double. Mariners back in Peoria at the Sports Complex today. They were hosting the Chicago Cubs earlier today, and it was the debut of Robbie Ray, making his first start since coming over from Toronto in the offseason. We'll have more on that tomorrow morning on Wake Up with Anchie Valley. Well, Seattle media got their first chance to meet Drew Locke Monday. The 25-year-old Missouri graduate came over from Denver in the blockbuster trade for Russell Wilson. He says he's happy to get another chance to prove himself with a new NFL team.
You know, I would say that I knew something was going to happen regardless. Something's happened in the quarterback room and almost every team in this league after every offseason. That just, it is what it is. That those type of things happen. I was ready for something to happen, and then when I found out that this is what happened, I was really, really excited. Excited for a fresh start, excited to come in and compete for a starting job and do everything I can to show this organization and show this league what I'm capable of doing, and that's playing really good football.
The 6'4", 228-pound quarterback says he's eager to work with offensive coordinator Shane Waldron on an offense that works for him.
Yeah, I obviously know a little bit about Coach Waldron's system. It's similar to the one that I ran my rookie year when I first got into the league, and you know, I got to play at the end of that year, and we played really good football. We won 4 of the 5 games, and I played efficient football, took care of the ball, scored in the red zone, hit the deep shots when they were there. And I just think that collectively as a group, you know, when we start talking and getting into the deep details of his offense and what might be good for me, what do they want to have for sure, I think we'll put it all together and then end up, you know, being able to put a good offense together that, you know, makes my skill set shine. And that's, I can throw the deep ball, I can move around in the pocket, I can play action, whatever you might need me to do, I'll be able to do it. And I think we're going to put a good plan together to be able to, you know, maximize my skill set.
Now, Locke wore number 3 in college at Missouri, as well as in Denver with the Broncos. He says he chose to wear number 2 in Seattle out of respect to Russell Wilson.
As long as football goes on, Russell Wilson will be very special to this place, very special to Seattle. And I know what it takes to kind of build a legacy. You know, you wouldn't go wear 18 in Indianapolis. You wouldn't go wear 12 in Green Bay. It's a sign of respect for him from me, but also at the same time, I want to write my own story here. You know, I want to see what 2 does for us. You know, I want to make that me. You know, I don't want to fight against Russell. He's done so many great things for this place and so many great things for the city of Seattle and the state of Washington that, you know, I want 2 to remember it as Drew Locke, not 3 was Russell and Drew. I want 2 to be Drew, and that's just kind of been my mindset on it. I have the utmost respect for him, and that was kind of a move in showing that.
In other Seahawks news, Seattle agreed to a 1-year contract to bring back running back Rashad Penny. NFL Network's Ian Rappaport says Penny passed on more money to stay in Seattle.
Just feel like this home, you know, trying to build off of what happened last year and the success, and, you know, just get back to, you know, building these tradition ways of winning. You know, like I said at the end of the press, this just felt like home. I was more comfortable here. You know, I think I got in a rhythm and a groove, you know, with the guys in the offense. So, I mean, it was just kind of – it was like a no-brainer for me to know where to come back to.
Penny says the news of Russell Wilson's trade was a shock and he'll be missed in Seattle, but that it's time to move forward and create a new tradition.
Obviously, that's a big piece. And, you know, ever since I've been in the league, Russ has taught me to be the best pro and be the best version of myself. And, you know, I feel like it's like him leaving a legacy here and we just picking off where he left off. I mean, you know, you can't really, you know, get anybody like that again. But we're thankful to have Drew Lock, and, you know, I'm behind him and I'm with him. And I think everybody else here, you know, are on the same board. So it's just a new legacy that's starting here in Seattle.
Now, Penny joins a running back room that still includes Chris Carson, Alex Collins, and Adrian Peterson, the man who changed Rashad's approach to the game last season. Well, the Seattle Kraken are going to try to do something tonight they haven't done since January, and that's string two wins back-to-back. Seattle takes its 19-38-6 record on the road to face 20-38-4 Arizona Coyotes tonight in Gia River Arena. The puck will drop at 7 o'clock, and you can see the action on Root Sports Northwest. Meanwhile, the Wenatchee Wild set to play their last home game of the regular season tomorrow night at the Town Toyota Center. The Penticton V's are in town for the 6 o'clock game, having already wrapped up the league's best record, the number one playoff spot, and the BCHL's regular season championship. Wenatchee's flying high with a four-game winning streak, but are 0-5 against the V's so far this season. We'll have more on a preview tomorrow morning on Wake Up Wenatchee Valley with our good friend, Arch Ecker. Well, here we have our first broadcast of the spring sports season coming up this Saturday. Wenatchee hosts Kamiokin in boys lacrosse at Lee Bofto Field at the Apple Bowl. I'll be alongside Thomas Bass with the action at 5 o'clock here on the NCW Life Channel. It'll be the third game of the week for Wenatchee, who opened the season last night at Sela with a 14-8 win. They'll also play at Richland Friday before hosting the Braves on Saturday. Here's what's on tap for Pret Sports scheduled today. A lot of these are already underway. At Baseball Diamonds, West Valley visiting Wenatchee, while Moses Lake is hosting Eisenhower. Fred is at Quincy. Liberty Bell's at Chelan. Cascade is hosting Lake Roosevelt. Fast pitch softball today. Games underway. Wenatchee hosting Cashmere. Quincy's hosting Ephrata. Lake Roosevelt's at Cascade, while Brewster is hosting OMAC. Boys soccer this afternoon. Cascade's at OMAC. Tenasket's hosting Bridgeport. Okanagan's at Brewster. And Oroville welcomes Okanagan. Cashmere takes on Quincy at 6 o'clock. Then tonight at 7, it's Davis at Eastmont. Wenatchee at Skyline. And Moses Lake travels to West Valley. That's a look at sports news. I'm Eric Grandstrom. Grant, back to you.
Thanks a bunch, Eric. And now let's check in with Dan Kuntz for a look at what's coming up tomorrow morning on Wake Up Wenatchee Valley. Dan?
Thanks, Grant. Tomorrow is Wednesday, according to my calendar. And every Wednesday throughout the course of the hockey season, we talk Wenatchee Wild Hockey. Arch Ecker will be joining us. They have one more regular season home game. That's tomorrow against Penticton. A couple of games on the road over the weekend. They wrap it up on the 27th, and then it's playoff time. And the Wild are playing good hockey. They've won four in a row. We'll talk to Arch on tomorrow's Wake Up Wenatchee Valley. Your very warm and pleasant weather forecast and everything else you need to start your hump day Wednesday tomorrow. We're live and local at 7 a.m. right here on Wake Up Wenatchee Valley. Grant, back to you.
Thank you very much, Dan. And that's going to do it for our newscast tonight. For more on these stories and other news from around North Central Washington, you can find us on Facebook or our website at ncwlife.com. And remember, if you see news happening, we'd like to hear from you. You can send us an email at news@ncwlife.com or give us a call at 888-6295. I'm Grant Olson. Thanks for joining us and have a great night.